Losses in the early years of the billion-dollar casinos of Metro Manila and uneven earnings in 2016 have led to disappointing performances in share price for the likes of Bloomberry, Travelers International, Melco Crown, Premium Leisure, and Bell Corporation. That isn't the case this 2017. With the exception of Travelers, gaming shares have shined this quarter. Solaire operator Bloomberry is up 23% year-to-date, while the trio behind the City of Dreams are surging, while Melco Crown up nearly 60% as of Tuesday. Travelers is lagging behind after reporting drops in sales and profits in 2016. In contrast, Melco Crown's earnings were through the roof in the fourth quarter. Bloomberry has yet to report, but its third quarter results were already impressive. Migs Lopez of AB Capital Investment says the numbers look good.
Gross gaming revenues, or GGRs, at above 20% actually, with the Pagcor recording 25% increase in their GGR. And this is actually reflected by some of the gaming names.
Lopez, however, stressed there is a need to see more consistent earnings from the sector.
It depends now on whether these are sustainable earnings, that's number one. And number two, whether gross gaming revenues for 2017 and for 2018 would be sustained above 20%. They have seen quite a volatile earnings here for the past 2 years.
Also weighing on the industry, regulatory risk. President Rodrigo Duterte himself has voiced his personal dislike for gambling, specifically online gaming. One company has bore the brunt, PhilWeb Corporation, formerly led by Roberto Ongpin. The company's license to provide the network for Bagcor's online gaming cafes wasn't renewed last year, and President Duterte branded Ongpin an oligarch who, quote, must be destroyed. Since then, PhilWeb has repositioned as an actual online gaming cafe operator. It just acquired a location in Tarlac. President Dennis Valdez, however, is hoping they can restart their business as a service provider for Pagcor.
Our new chairman, Greg Araneta, remains very bullish about the process that we're going through with Pagcor to be able to restart our business. And he's of the opinion that we'll be able to get it in due time. Of course, nobody wants to put any milestones because we don't know how long that the process will take, both within Pagcor and within ourselves, to be able to get it all done.
For now, it appears the safer bet would be on the big casinos in Pasay. Warren de Guzman, ABS-CBN News.